Haven't you had enough, Mr. Calderasha's hair? I'm sorry, but I've got a business to run. This, haphazard fortune-telling of yours is costing me a fortune in free drinks.
What? My fortune-telling? Haphazard? Are you a complete fool? Let me tell you something for free. All fortune-telling is haphazard. What do you expect? Anyway, so what if I saw it? So what if I foretold the fire? If I tried to stop it, then what? It would only have led to another disaster. That's what.
I'm sorry, Mr. Calderasha, sir. I don't follow. If you're saying you knew about the fire, shouldn't you at least have warned Master Rylus?
Yes, poor Rylus. How many times I argued with the old man. I cannot believe he's gone. What? What is it? You! Come, show your face to the great Calderasha. Yes, yes.
Quick, quick! Everyone come quick! There's a monster in town! Just come and see! The whole town's gone crazy!
What the? This ain't good, Gav. Come on! Look lively! Well, that was a fine reception. Don't they realize who I am? Judging a book by its cover, don't they know it's what's inside that counts?
Yeah, you can say that again.
So then, did you manage to find Master Rylus? What? He's dead? Oh, no, no, no! Well, I suppose there's no point crying over spilt milk. It's Dulmagus we're after. He's the one who cursed the princess and I, after all. He's the one who made us look so ridiculous. I had hoped Rylus might be able to help us locate him. But it seems we'll just have to track Dulmagus down by ourselves.
With Rylus gone, we have nothing further to gain from staying here. Let's be on our way.
Wait. Please wait. I'm sorry to come running after you like this. It's just that I wanted to ask you a favor.
Are you not afraid of me, young lady?
I dreamt about you. I dreamt that some people came to town with a strange creature. It was sort of halfway between a human and a monster. And I dreamt that they could make wishes come true.
A strange creature? Are you referring to me?
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to be rude.
Not to worry. I've had worse things said to me today. You know, you remind me of my Medea. You're about the same age. Anyway, you say you had a dream about me. Most peculiar.
I'm sorry. I haven't even introduced myself. I'm Valentina, daughter of the great fortune teller Caldarasha. If you could just come to my house, I'll explain everything there. It's by the well, at the far end of town. I'll be waiting for you!
What was she rabbiting on about? Come round my house, she says.
Magnificent! She wasn't afraid to look at me at all, not one bit. Oh, she reminds me of my Medea. We must give this young girl a helping hand. Right then, my boy. Go and find the house by the well and see what it is she wants. Hmm? Me? I'll wait here with the princess. We don't want to cause any more of a stir.